in the world of academic science, there's kind of this dichotomy sometimes between the strategy of being a successful scientist, well-published, well-funded, and just the inherent, you know, love and pursuit of new scientific knowledge. And sometimes those two things don't necessarily end up, you know, being as parallel maybe as we all wish they were. And we get a little bit, you know, you can get very caught up in that. You can get very caught up in, you know, a lot of the, you know, the competitiveness of science. And, you know, my colleague Howard Stricker and I, you know, often commented that, you know, when you get into this kind of frenzy of the academic world, it's always nice to step back and go and talk to Keerti, who we both refer to often as the Buddha, because, you know, no matter how anxious you are, Keerti's always going to have some just, you know, brilliant insight that really more or less kind of stabilizes you and, you know, grounds you back into the reality of what we're doing and why we're doing it. Having him be able to listen to me, and he often listens to me go on and talking for, you know, hours at a time with saying very little. But then after he's let me go on, he generally can stop and say just, you know, a couple of things that make it all, you know, better, and the perspective is back, and you can just kind of move forward. So Keerti and I have worked together. I came to the school as a PhD student in epidemiology with the intention to bridge my molecular biology background, which is where I had overlapped the most with Keerti in the past, with my new knowledge of epidemiology. And so Keerti played an important advisory role to me during that time and was really the person, as a matter of fact, who encouraged me to apply for a faculty position at Hopkins, which is something I don't know that I had previously given much thought to. And as we were kind of, you know, discussing career advice, and he was really kind of helping me to kind of know the things that somebody should think about in terms of what's going to set you on to, you know, a successful career path in academic science. He asked a really interesting question, and it always comes back to me, and he just kind of stopped the conversation and said, "Patti, you don't think you're Einstein, do you?" And it's a typical Keerti statement, you know, which was his way of saying, you know, look, you know, we're not going to necessarily, you know, develop quantum theory, right? But the things we do are fundamental and they're important and they impact millions of lives. And so again, it's a matter of Keerti really kind of grounding it into what's important in public health. And that is something that I find to be, from Keerti, one of, it's something that I value incredibly in terms of his mentorship for me in a very competitive and driven environment, is that, you know, Keerti always believed this is not about necessarily your career advancement. It's not about your getting more papers out. It's about making a difference in the world. And it is incredibly refreshing and inspiring to have a mentor who believes it, first of all, with all of his heart, and teaches you how to live that as an academic science.